All right. Hello, everyone. Larry Lewis here again. Today, I'm focusing on a continuation of what I started in my last video, which was a focus on what will you be known for or remember for, dear Father. Today, my focus is on the scripture that talks about a righteous man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. Now, before I continue, one thing I want us to know is that we know in part and we prophesy in part. By the special grace of God, I am saved, but by the blood of Jesus and by the grace of God, I've been able to walk on this path for a couple of years. And I share this even to help us fathers to have an understanding of some of the demands of God upon our lives as fathers. Now, listen to this. Every father have a special authority, special privilege over their children. Now, there's something that we need to understand about God. God is a God of generations. Now, when we talk about leaving an inheritance for your children's children, it is not about wealth or anything like that. It's about building the capacity to walk and to know God in the life of that child. Every seed of your loin must be able to have a personal walk with God to the extent that without you being there, they will be able to go on. When you look at the life of Isaac, when he was about to bless Jacob, Jacob left the house of his father with just a shepherd's stick. When Joseph was sold to slavery, he had nothing. He was sold as a slave. But when Jacob got to the house of Laban, the Bible says that Laban said, since you came here, we have noticed a difference. We have flourished more in our family, in our business. When Joseph got to the house of Potiphar, Potiphar was so perplexed. He said that, I know God is with you. It is the God in the life of Joseph that made the difference. And so, even when he got to the prison, even the person that was the prison head, made him head because there was something different. So, when we talk about an inheritance is something that you give as a valuable treasure. Having a personal walk with God is a valuable treasure that you must hand over to every seed of your loin. Let them have a personal walk with God. Let them know God themselves. Let them be able to build an understanding of the patterns and the workings of God. When they know this, you have set them on the path of soaring, on the path of phenomenal success in their life. Because he that has God will have the Spirit of God infused to his own spirit. And the Bible says that there may be so many thoughts in the heart of man, but the Lord gives him direction. It means that the person will not be without direction. So if you help your children, whether they are boys or they are girls, young adults, whoever they are, to build the capacity to understand the workings of God, to have a personal relationship with God, God will give them direction. They will be quickened by the Spirit even to know what to do per time, per season. They will be able to understand the seasons that they are in. They will be able to know what to do. They will be rightly connected. And one thing that you need to understand is that when the presence of God goes with somebody, they will always attract favor. They will always attract all the resources of heaven. Remember, God is the one that has control over everything. And so the best inheritance that you can hand over to your children is a capacity to understand how to work with God and to begin the work using you as an example, as a perfect example, mentoring them. Because as Paul said, he said, the things that we do, the things that we have heard and that we are doing are the things that we are asking you to do. Follow me as I am also a follower of Christ. Let that child follow you as you have also been following, because you are the first example, you are the first model for that child. Dear Father, as I round up this session this day, know this: wealth, affluence is bonus. Walk with God is it. Thank you.